Friends, in this topic, we are detailedly study how we can find out and measurement the moment of inertia of a electrical drive. So let's begin. Friends, measurement of moment of inertia, it will be very, very important bit as concerned with the university examination point of view, because most of the time in university examination such kind of question is basically asked for the 5 marks, and that the question is called as how the moment of inertia will be calculated by the means of the different way. So guys, the moment of inertia, the symbol of the moment of inertia is called as J, and that can be calculated in a basically 2 ways. So the first way for the calculation of the measurement of moment of inertia, that the method is called as the theoretical calculation. So what do you mean by the theoretical calculation? Up till now, we have derived some of the equivalent parameter of an electrical drive. So from that particular parameter, if we know the dimensions, if we know the weight of the various parts of the load and the motor are known, then we can simply find out the value of the moment of inertia. So that will be the first method to calculate the value of the polar moment of inertia. And the second method is called as by the practical means. What do you mean by the practical means? So we are conducting one of the practical to find out the value of the measurement of moment of inertia, and that practical is called as by the retardation test. So from retardation test, we can get the value of the measurement of moment of inertia. So guys, this is very, very important bit. We will start to the first method for the calculation of the measurement of moment of inertia, and that the first method is called as the theoretical method. So in theoretical method, in the last few sessions, we have already derived the various parameters of the electrical drive by the means of the different 2 types of motion. Basically, in the subject of electrical drives, the drive is called as the system employed for motion control. If we are applying the electrical motors for the motion control, then it is called as the electrical drive. So in day-to-day life, we are using, there are 2 types of different of motion. First type of motion is called as the rotational motion, and second one type of motion is called as the translational motion. Another name of the rotational motion is called as the circular motion. Another name of the translational motion is called as the linear motion. And that will be the basic concepts of physics. And we have already derived the equation of the J, that is polar moment of inertia. That is J is equal to J0 plus J1 square J1. What do you mean by the value of A1? Where J1 is called as the gear tooth ratio. And the J1 is called as the polar moment of inertia of that particular load inertia. Okay, so it is called as the value of the load inertia plus the value of J2, that is the connected the second load's gear tooth ratio and the polar moment of inertia of the second load, plus dash up to, if we are connecting the m number of loads, then the gear tooth ratio of the m load and the polar moment of inertia of the m load. So by the means of that particular formula with the rotational motion, we can find out or measurement the value of the J, that is polar moment of inertia of that particular motor. Okay, so that would be the first method for the rotational motion. If we know the motion which is called as a translational motion, so in a translational motion, the another name of the translational motion is called as the linear motion. So by the means of the translational motion, we can get the value of the J, that is polar moment of inertia, and that J is equal to basically J0 plus M1 in bracket V1 divided by omega M bracket square. So what do you mean by the J0? J0 is called as the polar moment of inertia connected to the first load. Then the second load, the M1 is called as the mass of that particular object. Then V1 is called as the linear velocity, that is in concern with the translational motion. and the omega m is called as the angular velocity in concern with the that body and the whole bracket square. So this will be the considering for the first load. And the second load, if we are connecting a second load to the translational motion, then m2 is called as the mass of that particular object, v2 is called as the velocity, that is linear velocity, the omega m is called as the angular velocity and the whole bracket square. If we are connecting the m number of loads into that particular translational motion, then we are getting the simple equation of the J, that is polar moment of inertia, that is capital M small m, that is the load which is called as mm, that is mass for the m load, into vm, that is the linear velocity for the m load, divided by the omega m. Omega m is called as the angular velocity, whole bracket square. So from that particular equation, now we are getting the value of the J, that is polar moment of inertia for the translational motion. So guys, in this way, we have already measured the value of the polar moment of inertia if we know any other parameter of the electrical drift. Okay, so these parameters may be your dimensions, weight, and various parts of load and motor are known. Then we are getting the value of the polar moment of inertia. That will be the first method to calculate the value of the moment of inertia. Okay, so from the first method, we will start to get the second method for the calculation of the J, polar moment of inertia. So guys, especially in the examination, such kind of question is asked, how the polar moment of inertia is calculated by the retardation test, by the means of the measurement of the moment of inertia. Then you have to explain this whole methodology of the retardation test. So basically, that retardation test is conducting on the motor. So what do you mean by the first of all retardation test? We can understand, guys, in retardation test, we know, the name itself indicates its meaning. What do you mean by the retardation test? So in retardation test, what will happen in retardation test, we are basically the drive or the motor which will be running slightly greater than the rated speed. Means if the motor, suppose we are running at according to the fundamental thing, if the motor will be running at the 1500 rpm, so for conducting of the retardation test, now we can run this motor or this drive slightly greater than the rated speed. It means we are just moving that particular motor on slightly greater than the rated speed, because rated speed is 1500. Now we are increasing the value of the speed of that particular drive is 1500 rpm. Okay, then suddenly we are cut off the supply. Means if the motor rated speed is 1500 rpm, for the conduction of the retardation test, we are increasing the value of the speed of your motor, and then the supply is suddenly cut off. If we are suddenly cut off the supply, then what will happen? So this drive will be continuously running while the supply is removed. Still the motor is continuously running. Why it is running? Due to its stored kinetic energy, and decelerate due to its rotational mechanical losses. Guys, understand, in retardation test, what we are doing, that we are increasing the speed of your motor slightly greater than the rated speed, and suddenly we are cutting off that particular supply. So if we are cutting out of this supply, still the motor will be running. Why the motor will be running? Due to its stored kinetic energy, and this motor is decelerate due to its rotational mechanical losses. Okay, then at that time we can record various speed reading. So at that time we can record what? Various speed reading in concern with the retardation test at any speed of omega m. Means at the any value of the speed of the omega m, the power consumed by supplying rotational losses is given by, that is the power consumed supplying rotational losses is given by, according to the power formula, that is P is equal to the rate of change of kinetic energy in terms of fact, the rate of change of kinetic energy. So we have the fundamental formula of the rate of kinetic energy, 1/2 mv². So that will be 1/2, that is j into omega m square, because m is converted into j, v is converted into the angular velocity. So we have the fundamental formula of the rate of change of kinetic energy, that is 1/2 j omega m² and the rate, that's why we are taking the derivative. So by the taking of the derivative of basically this term, we can getting the value that is called as j omega m into d omega m by dt, and that will be the value of the power, that is p, that will be the value of the power which will be conducted on that particular rotational losses, and that rotational losses power is called as j into j, that is j into j omega m into d omega m by dt. So this is the value which is called as the power consumed by the supplying rotational losses. So by means of that particular power, we are getting one of the value of that particular power. If we know the value of the power, if you know the value of rate of change of speed with respect to time, then simply we can calculate the value of the j. So that will be the first very important understanding method. So from that particular equation, again, I can write here the equation, that is p is equal to j omega m, that is d omega m by dt. So from retardation test, we are getting this value. If we know the value of the angular velocity, if we know the value of the angular velocity with respect to time, if we know this term, if you know this term, if you know this term, if you know this term, then we can simply calculate the value of j. Okay, so this will be the retardation test, and from the retardation test we can getting the value of p, we can getting the value of omega m, we can getting the value of omega m with respect to time t. So from these parameters, that is p, omega m and d omega m by dt, we can simply calculate the value of the j. So this will be the first method for understanding of the retardation test, and from that particular test now we can getting, that is from retardation test, obviously we are getting the value of the d omega m by dt at a rated speed is obtained. Okay, from retardation test what we are getting, the rate of change of speed with respect to time. Why we are getting this the value, that is the rate of change of speed with respect to time? Because in, as we know that in retardation test what we are doing, we are just the increasing of the speed of your motor at slightly greater than the rated speed, and suddenly we are cutting off the supply. The motor will be continuously running due to its kinetic energy, and at that time we can measure different values of speed with respect to time, and that is the speed with respect to time will be measured with the help of the retardation test. Okay, so we are getting, that is the first term. So after that, getting the value of the d omega m by dt, now drive is again reconnected to the supply, and again it will be run at a rated speed. Means what? Again we are reconnecting this supply, and again it will be running at a rated speed, that is rated speed is 1500 rpm, and at that time we can measure the different values of the rotational losses. At that time we can measure the different value of the rotational mechanical input, that is rotational mechanical input which is called as p. Now we can measure the value of the p. So if we know the value of the p, that the value of p is basically approximately is equal to the previous equation, that is the previous equation is what, that is p is equal to, basically that the equation is called as basically p is equal to j into, basically we have this fundamental equation, that is p into g omega m, that is p into, basically we have the value, that is p into g omega m plus d omega m by dt. So from that particular thing we will get the value of now p. How we are getting the value of p? Again we are connecting this drive or this motor to the supply, and we can measure the input power, that is p. So if you know the value of p, if you know the value of omega m, if we are getting this value from the retardation test, that is the decrease in value of the speed with respect to time, we are getting the value of P, we are getting the value of omega m, we are getting the value of J, that is d omega m by dt by retardation test. So if we know this parameter, then simply we can calculate the value of the J, that is called as the polar moment of inertia by means of the retardation test. So that will be the concept of the understanding. Then basically the main problem in this method is what? The rotational mechanical losses cannot be separated, because in that particular thing we cannot separate the rotational losses in concern with that the power, that is a P. So this will be the drawback of this system. So for overcome of that particular drawback, now we can using the another method for the finding out the J, that is polar moment of inertia, accurately. And that method of the finding out the J polar moment of inertia is called as basically the graphical method. So what we are doing in that particular graphical method, let's we can understand, because in the retardation test we are getting some of the graph in concern with the retardation test. So this will be the graphical method by which we can getting the accurately value of the J polar moment of inertia. So in retardation test, basically we are conducting the two type of curve that will be the drawn with the help of the retardation test. The first curve is called as speed time curve, okay, that is speed time curve of retardation test. And the second curve is called as a rotational losses versus speed plot, means by the retardation test we have to finding out the value of the J, that is called as polar moment of inertia. And for finding out that polar moment of inertia, one of the very accurate method which is called as graphical method. And for that particular graphical method, we want to draw some of the curve, some of the graph, that is the first graph is speed versus time curve, and the second graph which is called as rotational losses versus speed plot. So guys, let's we'll start to understand that the concept of the curve. So as shown in figure, we are getting first of all the value of the first, that is speed and time curve. This will be the curve number first, that is speed and time curve. And second curve, that is the rotational losses, that is the P is called as the rotational losses versus the value of the speed. Means from retardation test we can draw the two curves. The first curve is plot against, that is speed versus time, and second curve is called as P, that is the rotational losses in terms of the angular velocity. So as we know that the omega m is called as angular velocity, the unit that is radian per second of that particular angular velocity, the unit of time, that is t in terms of seconds, okay. Then the P is called as the rotational losses, the unit in terms of watt, and the speed again, that is in terms of radian per second. So these are the two graphs. So the first graph, as we have seen, that is from the retardation test, we can get the value of angular velocity with respect to time. So in retardation test, what we are doing, that we are just running the motor, that is the rated speed. We are increasing again speed slightly greater than the rated speed, and at that time we are just removing the supply. So at that time the value of the speed is look like that, but while we are removing the supply, then the speed of your motor is slightly decreasing. So we can record this reading with respect to, that is the speed reading with respect to time. So we can get the curve look like that shape. So we can get the curve look like that shape, and that the curve is called as the speed versus time curve, that is the rate of change of speed with respect to time by the retardation test. And this will be the first graph for retardation test of basically we called it as the omega m versus t. So this will be the first part. So guys, in retardation test again we can connect, after getting the value of the rate of change of speed with respect to time, again we can connect this type of drive into the supply, for the rated speed, and at that time we can measure the value of the power, that is called as rotational losses, that is a power delivered by the motor. We can measure the value of the P, giving concern with the value of the speed. So now from that particular value of the power and speed, we can plot one graph, and that graph is basically called as the P versus omega m graph. This graph is called as P versus omega m graph, m graph. So from that particular two graphs, we can get the value of the J, that is called as polar moment of inertia. Now, how we can get the value of this polar moment of inertia? By means of two graphs. So as we know that the omega m is called as speed, P is called as rotational losses, T is called as time. So by the combination of this curve number 1 and curve number 2 in a particular one graph, we can getting the value of P1, and that the P1 is called as the basically power developed by your motor. So for the sake of understanding, we will move towards the next slides. So in next slides, what will happen, we are just combining these two graphs in a single plane. So the first graph is the value of the speed versus time, and the value of rotational losses versus speed. So we are just combining these two graphs in a particular plane. So guys, we can getting the first, that is the draw, which is called as, it is a first draw, that is a first draw, means this will be the first graph, that is the basically graph which will be drawn, that is omega m versus t, that we had already discussed earlier. So this will be the combination of the first and second graph. So this will be the first graph, and the second graph is as shown, that is the graph which is plotting, that is P versus omega m. So this will be the combination of first and second graph at a particular plane. So as we know that for the sake of the first graph, we are plotting, now I can basically change the symbol, that is the first graph is shown by the omega m and t, and the second graph is basically shown by the P versus omega m. So we can getting the value. Now I can show the first graph with the different color, that is the first graph will be shown by the, that is the value of the omega m versus t, and the second graph will be shown by the red color, that is called as P versus omega. So from that particular two curves, that is curve number 1 and curve number 2, we can getting the third curve. The third curve is basically the combination. Again, I can draw this small curve for the sake of your understanding. So this will be the first curve that we will draw. That is first curve will be draw with the help of the omega m versus t. The second curve, that will be the plot, that is P versus omega m. Now we are taking, so this will be the first curve, this will be the second curve. So the combination of first and second curve, we are getting the third curve. And third curve is what? We are getting the third curve by the taking one of the parameter of the second curve and one of the parameter of the first curve, and that curve is called as P versus T, means we are taking the first one of the term in the that particular curve and one of the term in the that particular curve, and that will give you the third curve, and that will be the shown by the dotted line. So as shown in figure, we are getting the third curve from curve number first and second, and that third curve is basically shown by P versus T curve. So that will be getting from the resultant of the curve number 1 and curve number 2. So this will be the third curve, which will be from that particular curve, we can getting the value of the P1. We can getting the value of the P1 by means are taking one of the reference value, that is called as P1. And we are getting the value of omega m. So this value of omega m we are taking from the graph number first, that is omega m. So this will be the value of P1, this will be the value of omega m. So From that value of the P1 and omega m, we can get directly the value of P1, and where the value from the P1, that will be the power from the motor. So from that curve, we are getting the value of P directly instead of by the measurement of the input power. So we are getting directly the value of the P. So if you know the value of the P, then we can simply find out the value of the polar moment of inertia, that is J into omega m into d omega m by dt plus d omega m by dt. So from retardation test, we can get this value d omega m by dt. We are getting the value of the speed, that is the angular value of the speed. And from that particular graphical method, we have calculated the value of P1. So from graphical method, we can get the value of P. So from graphical method, what we are getting? We are getting basically the value of the P. What will be the value of P? So the value of P will be shown by here. So this will be the value of the P1. So from graphical method, we can get the accurate value of P1. So if you know the accurate value of P1, if you know the accurate value of the angular velocity, if you know the accurate value of d omega m by dt, then simply we can get the value of the J, that is polar moment of inertia, by the retardation test or by the means of this graphical method. So this will be the very, very accurate method for finding out the value of the J, that is called as polar moment of inertia. So in this way, we have studied the different methods to finding out the measurement of moment of inertia of the electrical drive. Thank you.